हेलो, वेलकम बैक फॉर द आईक्यूएम लेक्चर। नाउ लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड द आवर थर्ड मैनेजरियल फंक्शन स्टाफिंग। ओके, फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर प्लानिंग ऑर्गेनाइजिंग स्टाफिंग। ओके, सो ओनली टू रिमेनिंग, सो दैट टू मैनेजरियल फंक्शंस वी विल स्टडी इन नेक्स्ट चैप्टर। सो इन सेकंड चैप्टर आफ्टर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग नाउ स्टाफिंग, ओके, ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज एचआर, okay, human resource management, what is the procedure, selection procedure for the employee. So today we will study about the training and the performance appraisal of employee. Okay, so last lecture we have started the staffing. Okay, now what is the staffing? It is a filling and keeping filled position in the organization structure. Okay, so what are the recruitment process, okay, what are the advantages, what is the human resource management process, what are the required methods for the selection, okay, attraction, selection, training, assessment, rewarding. Now these are the functions or these are the requirement of the HR management. System approach to the staffing, which system, what is the external sources, what are the internal sources, okay, what is the selection, employee selection, which factors we should consider while selecting the employee. Now recruitment process basically divided into two types, internal sources and the external sources. Okay, and internal sources is nothing but the transfer inside whoever is the present, whoever is already employed of your industry. Okay, these are those are in internal sources in category. Okay, promotion is also same for internal. Now external is nothing but there are a lot of available external sources to recruit the employee. Okay, so recruitment, factory gate, casual callers, advertisement, okay, different agencies are there, management consultants are allowed, okay, educational institutions, okay, if you require the freshers, okay, so you can reach to educational institute as a campus drive. Okay, so recommendations, labor contractors, telecasting, so these are the recruitment sources. Okay, source of recruitment, internal sources and the external sources. What are the advantages, disadvantages, we already studied. Okay, now today we will start the point number, next point of the staffing, performance appraisal. Okay, now what is the meaning of that performance appraisal? Okay, this is very simple, name itself, performance appraisal. Okay, whatever the performance of that particular employee in your industry or in your organization, that we have to report in terms of report. Okay, so overall biodata, overall performance, overall CV, we can say that. Okay, or overall information of particular employee is nothing but the performance appraisal. Now why this is required? Okay, so you can understand, okay, we can tally whether our employee, okay, or to compare the employee also. Suppose if you required any internal sources, from internal sources, okay, so for the promotion, for the increment in salary, okay, for the awarding, so therefore performance appraisal is very important. So keep in mind, each and everywhere competition is there. Okay, now performance appraisal is also part of competition. Okay, so we have to stand anywhere, okay, anytime in that particular competition. Now how the behavior of that particular employee, okay, what are the rewarding quality of that employee, what is the work quality of that employee. Okay, now there are different factors, okay, for the analysis of that particular employee. Okay, basically performance appraisal is analysis of that employee, okay, within its working period, within its working period in that particular industry. Okay, whenever you will left that industry, all the performance appraisal will convert it into your resume or experience. Okay, so performance appraisal is a live status of your job, is it right? So keep in mind, everywhere, every time, someone is watching you. Okay, so for that purpose, our behavior, okay, our work quality, okay, our whatever the enthusiasm, again, lot of factors. Okay, so we should follow all the factors while considering the performance appraisal, definitely the output will definitely you will get. Okay, so there are different how we can identify the person or analysis of person may poor, okay, person may be developing, good or outstanding. So according to your nature, according to your behavior, work quality, according to your working capacity. Okay, so those factors are very important. Okay, so we will study what is actually definition of the performance appraisal. So we have to understand who is a working people. Okay, so all the study we are doing from the manager chair. Okay, at the start of your syllabus, we are assuming we are manager. So from the views of manager, so we have to understood all the things. Is it right? Now, performance appraisal, what is the definitions, what is the information? Okay, performance appraisal is a regular review of an employee job performance. Is it right? Very definition is very simple. The performance appraisal is a regular review of an employee job performance. Regular review. So for example, a performance appraisal for 1 year. Okay, from whatever the your financial year may be there, as per that organization. Okay, financial year may be there, academic year may be there. Okay, whatever the 6 month, okay, monthly, is it right? So that will be indefinite period of that performance appraisal. Okay, as per the company strategy or the organization strategy, okay, there will review of the regular performance of employee job, okay, as per their requirement and overall contribution to a company, whether that employee is doing very well. Okay, now analysis of that work, is it whether this employee is suitable for our industry, okay, in future also what will be the his performance quality, performance or output quality. So all the factors we can understand from that performance appraisal. Okay, who will write the performance appraisal? So third party, is it right? So whatever that manager also, okay, second party we can say that. Performance appraisal will be analyzed by the whatever the manager of that particular industry. Okay, so overall contribution to a company, this is nothing but the performance appraisal, also known as annual review, performance review of evaluation or employee appraisal. A performance appraisal evaluates and employee skills, achievements and growth or lack. Is it right? What are the factors, what are the points will be considered in performance appraisal? First point is a employee skill. Okay, which skill he is using. Suppose for example we are doing work in an industry. Okay, for example we are working on CATIA software, okay, but we should not be stopped there only. We have to try to learn new things. Okay, suppose you will give idea to that company's manager, sir, this is a CATIA software we are using, but for the better performance we can use another software also. Okay, so if you will give the whatever the extra or known things, okay, definitely innovative things, definitely that points will be considered in your performance appraisal. Okay, so what software, what things, okay, what are the shortcuts, what are the innovations, okay, what are the tricks we are using, different skills. So that factors are also included in the your performance appraisal. Okay, what is your work capacity, is it right? Now achievements also, okay, what achievements we have taken, okay, or you have received. So that also, for example, in annual whatever the meeting, okay, or sorry, annual gathering may, so there will be different awards are in industry also. Okay, suppose manufacturing industry is there, okay, so in that industry there are best employee award, okay, best quality award, so different types of award may be there. Okay, so that factors are also considered in the performance appraisal. Okay, and the growth also, growth or lack. Suppose we are doing very well work, that will be also considered. And if any lacuna in your work, that will also considered in that performance appraisal. Okay. Now, companies use performance appraisals to give employees big picture feedback on their work and to justify pay increases and the bonuses. Definitely. As well as last thing is very important as your growth. Okay. So when your growth will be there, only promotion. So no, not only promotion, but whatever the increment in your salary, okay, whatever the promotion, okay, what are the powers, for example, authority. Now that factors is also depending on the performance appraisal. Okay, so we have to consider that companies use, where the companies will use the, that factors to give employees big picture feedback on their work. Suppose is whatever the feedback of that particular employee will be published in the performance appraisal, or will they will get idea about performance appraisal in that performance appraisal given by certain manager. Okay, feedback on their work and to justify pay increases. Okay, whether according to that performance appraisal. Okay, so your increment is also depending on same, and bonuses also. Okay, suppose your work capacity or performance is better, definitely your salary will increase. Okay, in whatever number of period. Okay, suppose you will get promotion also. If your work, you are very lagging in your work, definitely demotion may be there. Okay, as well as termination. Okay, as well as termination decision. Okay. Now, termination is also considered in that performance appraisal. Okay, suppose you are not doing very well work, definitely they will terminate you. Okay, so then you have to left that job also. Termination म्हणजे तुम्हाला जे काढून टाकाय सुद्धा अधिकार इज कंपनी हॅविंग. ओके, सो टर्मिनेशन डिसिजन इज ऑल्सो विल बी टेकन ऑन दी अनालिसिस ऑफ परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल. ओके, सो दे कॅन बी कंडक्टेड ऍट एनी गिवन टाइम बट टेन टू बी अन्युअल. नाव परफॉर्मन्स फॉर दी परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल देअर इज नो एनी फिक्स्ड पिरियड. ओके, सो ऍज पर his requirement, as per industrial requirement, as per organization requirement, okay, they will conduct the performance appraisal anytime. Okay, but generally performance appraisal tend to be annually, semi-annually or quarterly, monthly. So okay, monthly also. Okay, but performance appraisal is generally annually, semi-annually or quarterly, as per the organization. Is it right? Suppose any educational institute is there. Okay, so annually or same annually performance appraisal will be there. Okay, but in terms of marketing, okay, suppose marketing organization is there, definitely there may be a performance appraisal on whatever the monthly, quarterly also. Okay, because according to that performance they have to change the role of that particular employee. Is it right? So performance appraisal is the whatever the time we have studied. Now, what are the objective of performance appraisal? Okay. Now, first objective is to unify the rating procedure. Now, what is the rating? Now, whatever the serial number, sequence of that particular employee. Okay, suppose we have to give the roll number or sorry, sequence number to the for any employee. So how we can decide? So according to the experience, according to whatever the education, okay, according to experience, according to skills. So now that performance appraisal will also will help to unify the rating procedure for the group of employee or particular employee. Okay, to maintain a record of each employee's performance in order to determine wages, incentives, pay, salary increase, transfer and promotion. Okay, because performance appraisal is required for the maintain a record of each and every employee. Okay, so according to the performance appraisal, okay, now we can determine the wages. Okay, what payment we have to give. Is it right? Incentive pay, for example, whatever the increment in salary increases. Okay, incentive pay is nothing but the incentives may be there. Okay, for example, traveling. If you are very better, or you can say that overtime. Okay, so that factor is will be also considered in that performance appraisal. Okay, salary increases definitely as per your performance yearly, okay, or biannually. So there will be salary increases will be considered through performance appraisal. Is it right? So next is in transfer and promotion also. Okay, suppose if you are doing very well in your whatever the given work, okay, so manager of that industry may give you chance to work next position. Okay, why? Because your experience is better. Okay, if they will think on that this experience is sufficient for this person for the to handle the top position. Okay, so then and then only also they will give transfer or they will give promotion to each department. Okay, suppose in any industry quality department, but if you consider owner of that industry or organization has started the new job or new branch to in any new area, okay, so then definitely you will get the transfer appointment. Okay, why? Because you are experienced. So according to the performance appraisal, that company will transfer to one branch to another branch or whatever the different whatever the available franchises of that them. Okay, so promotion transfer is also depending on the performance appraisal. Okay, to determine the need of training programs. Okay, definitely whether you will very good, so then and you suppose your work is in some lacunized area, so you have to give required training. So according to that performance appraisal you will get training. Okay, so that performance appraisal will help to determine the need for the training program for that group of people or for individual people. Is it right? Now next objective is to provide a check, to provide a check at the end of the probationary period of new employees. Okay, suppose to provide a check at the end of the probationary period for the new employee. Okay, whatever the period of your industry, so at the end of that your probationary period, okay, so they will check what is your quality, what is your experience, what is our work quality. Okay, so according to that we can find out the probationary period so of that particular employee also. Okay, to eliminate personal prejudices. Okay, to eliminate personal prejudices and develop develop a better knowledge and understanding of its employees. Okay, so whatever if any lacuna, if any personal lacuna is there. Okay, so with the help of performance appraisal, manager can take action. Okay, what in terms of action, which term of action they will transfer, they will give training to extra training to them. Okay, so all the factors are important for the performance appraisal of particular employee. Is it right? What are the benefits of the employee? Assist to enhance employee performance. Okay, be integrated with strategic vision. Is it right? So according to that particular employee, you can set your vision also. Okay, hike in salary and compensation definitely. Okay, promotions and transfer, the tools of inspiration. Okay, now according to if you required the any inspiration, any motivation to your employee, so according to the experience or whatever that performance appraisal you will give to that particular employee. Is it right? So that are the importance or benefits of the performance appraisal. Now some limitations are also there. Okay, accuracy of rating depends upon the factors in the assessment are relevant. Is it right? Now how they will understood, how they will analyze your or the how they will assessment your performance. Okay, so there may be some lacuna because whatever the assessments factors. Okay, suppose if any factors are there is not related to our area. Okay, because suppose for example management points definitely. Okay, suppose if you will in industry working on any quality department, okay, but in managerial level or management levels criteria may be zero, definitely there will be disturbance. Why? Because you are only related to that quality department, but in that particular option or in that particular assessment form. Okay, so there are the different points like management level also, government levels also. Okay, now this is a limitation. Sometimes proper weightage may not be given to the different quality to be rated. Is it right? Okay, sometimes also who shift. Okay, sometimes proper weightage may not be given to that employee. Why? Because of who is the performance analyzer. Okay, so according to them, तुमचं जर एखाद्या हा या गोष्टी आता कशा आतल्या गोष्टी आहेत बरोबर का, पण दॅट फॅक्टर शुड बी कन्सिडर्ड. दिस इज ऑल्सो लिमिटेशन, म्हणजे तुमच्या ओळखीचा असेल, मित्र असेल एखादा, तर तो काय होणार आहे, त्याचा परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर विल गिव्ह बेटर मार्क्स. ओके, बट तुमचं जर कोणाशी भांडण असेल किंवा पटत नसेल तर डेफिनेटली दॅट फॅक्टर्स मे अवॉइड. ओके, सो देअर आर डिफरंट मेथड्स ऑल्सो अवेलेबल टू रिमूव्ह द लिमिटेशन्स. ओके, लाईक म्हणजे काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला, पेपर चेकिंग असेसमेंट जे असतं ते आता कोणाला कोणाला पेपर माहीत नसतं बरोबर का, डेफिनेटली देअर विल बी पार्शलिटी आर डिफरंट फॅक्टर्स आर देअर. ओके, सो ड्यू टू देअर सम सिक्युरिटी इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ दी परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर. मग द ॲक्च्युअल रेटिंग ऑफ सब्जेक्टिव्ह फॅक्टर्स लाईक इनिशिएटिव्ह अँड द पर्सनॅलिटी ऑफ द एम्प्लॉईज मे नॉट बी सायंटिफिक लाईन्स. ओके, इज वेदर दॅट पर्सन इज व्हेरी इनिशिएटिव्ह. ओके, सो दॅट फॅक्टर्स मे नॉट बी इन्क्लुडेड इन युअर वॉट इव द परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायज. वाय? बिकॉज इनिशिएटिव्ह इज ओनली वन पर्सन. ओके, आर ओनली वन आर मिनिमम पर्सन. सो फॉर द मिनिमम पर्सन दे विल नॉट ऍट द क्रायटेरिया ऑफ दॅट इनिशिएटिव्ह अँड द पर्सनॅलिटी ऑफ दॅट एम्प्लॉय. ओके, सो सम लॅकुनाज आर देअर इन परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल ऑल्सो. समटाईम्स सुपेरियर्स डू नॉट पजेस द क्रिटिकल ॲबिलिटी इन असेसिंग द स्टाफ. डेफिनेटली. ओके, प्रत्येक वेळेस तुमचा अधिकारी जो असेल, ओके, मॅनेजर, दे विल नॉट पजेस द क्रिटिकल ॲबिलिटी इन द असेसिंग द स्टाफ. काय वेळेस त्यांच्या लक्षात येऊ शकत नाही. ओके, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट कंटिन्युअसली टचिंग विथ युअर वॉट एवर द युअर. ओके, ओनली अकॉर्डिंग टू युअर क्वालिटी, अकॉर्डिंग टू शॉर्ट टाईम. ओके, म्हणजे हे 12 महिने जर ऑडिट असेल किंवा परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर असेल तर तो 12 महिने काय तुमच्याकडे लक्ष ठेवून नसतोय. इज इट राईट? सो दे विल ओनली वॉच यू, दे विल हँडल ॲट द टाईम ऑफ परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर ओनली. म्हणजे 2-4 दिवसात जर करायचं असेल परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर तर 2-3 दिवस तो कन्सिडर करेल, पण वर्षभर जे आपण काम केलेलं असतं प्रामाणिकपणानं ते एखाद दिवस कन्सिडर होऊ शकत नाही. सो दॅट इज नथिंग बट द लिमिटेशन, वन ऑफ द लिमिटेशन. द मेथड ऑफ परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझर्स आर अनरिलायबल. इज इट राईट? सो सम मेथड्स आर ऑल्सो अनरिलायबल. सो दॅट फॅक्टर्स आर ऑल्सो वी हॅव डिस्कस. सो वी विल स्टडी द नेक्स्ट पॉईंट. मेथड्स ऑफ परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल. ओके, रँकिंग मेथड. दीज आर द मेथड्स ऑफ परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल. रँकिंग मेथड, पेअर्ड कंपॅरिझन मेथड, ओके, ग्रेडिंग सिस्टीम, फोर्स डिस्ट्रीब्युशन मेथड, चेकलिस्ट मेथड, फ्री एसी मेथड, ग्राफिक स्केल. ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस शॉर्टली. इज इट राईट? हां, पेस्ट युअर रोल नंबर शेअर. डोंट जॉईन लेट. हा अण्णा, सो सम मेथड्स ऑफ द परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल. ओके, नाव फर्स्ट इज अ रँकिंग मेथड. ओके, सो वॉट इज अ रँकिंग मेथड? सो सपोज फॉर एक्झाम्पल युअर एक्झामिनेशन मे बी दिए. ओके, इन दॅट एक्झामिनेशन वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर ऑल दी पॉईंट्स. ओके, सपोज टेक एक्झाम्पल ऑफ वॉट एवर द कल्चरल इव्हेंट्स. ओके, सो आय एम गिविंग very small example. Okay, for the ranking measure. So what are the criteria for the suppose for example, if there any speech competition is there. Okay, so how we can analyze that speech competition? Suppose there are number of students giving the number of different speech. Okay, so what are the criteria? So for example, we have to give the 100 marks. Okay, inside that 100 mark there are the 10 factors. Okay, for example, first is what is your voice. Okay, what is confidence level? So out of 10 mark, whatever 8 mark will be given, 7 mark as per that confidence of that particular whatever person. Okay, so next criteria may be for the voice. Okay, what is your body language? Is it right? What is your gesture, posture? Okay, so all the factors are also very important, and after at the end the addition may be there. Okay, out of 100 what marks we have received. Okay, so according to that marks also we have to give the ranking to the each and every employee. Okay, so first method is the ranking. So in that ranking there are different points. Okay, now period comparison method. Now next method is the comparison method. Now they will compare one employee to the another employee, or one employee to the number of employees. So suppose for example we have to write the performance appraisal in industry. Okay, for example, we will consider, okay, who is a initiative from group of people. म्हणजे त्या गर्दीतून सर्च करायचं. ओके, पेअर्ड कंपॅरिझन मेथड. इज इट राईट? पेअर्ड कंपॅरिझन मेथड इज नथिंग बट वी हॅव टू सिलेक्ट ॲज पर द क्रायटेरिया. ओके, ॲज पर द क्रायटेरिया दिस इज नथिंग बट द पेअर्ड कंपॅरिझन मेथड. ओके, म्हणजे इथं काय करतोय बघा आपण पहिल्यामध्ये we have taken the analysis of all the employee. Okay, but in second pair comparison we have to select only as per the criteria. Okay, with the help of comparison. For example, who is the initiative? So we will compare from 100 employee. This 1, 2, 3 employees are very initiative. Okay, what is the next? What is the quality? What is the skill? As per skill. So this is nothing but the comparison method. Okay, now grading system. What is the grading system? So as like ranking method. Okay, so different grades you have to take. For example, suppose in your industry, okay, which in how much time you have completed your work, okay, as compared to other. Okay, for example, if you are having one work we have to complete within 20 minutes. Okay, but if you will give 20 minutes, definitely you will get A grade. If you will finish that work within 18 minutes, you will get A plus. Okay, A plus plus. So that is nothing but the grading system. Okay, suppose the as like in ranking method, now something slots are there. Okay, म्हणजे 25 ते 30 mark ज्यांना मिळाले ते A grade. Okay, म्हणजे जर असं वाटत असेल तुम्हाला, म्हणजे आता जे काय म्हणतो आपण, आता ग्रेडिंग सिस्टीम आली आपल्याकडं एक्झाममध्ये, बरोबर का? म्हणजे पहिला दुसरा नंबर जे पूर्वी होता फर्स्ट रँक सेकंड रँक, तो आता नाही हायस्कूलमध्ये वगैरे. ओके, माध्यमिक किंवा उच्च माध्यमिकमध्ये. सो दॅट इज नथिंग बट द ग्रेडिंग सिस्टीम. ओके, फोर्स डिस्ट्रीब्युशन मेथड. ओके, नाव फोर्स डिस्ट्रीब्युशन मेथड इज नथिंग बट सपोज वी वॉन्ट टू आयडेंटिफाय द नाव यू विल गेट द एक्झामिनेशन. ओके, म्हणजे तुम्ही काय करणार, एखाद्या वेळेस अचानकच एक्झाम घेणार फोर्सडी. Okay, to search whether the to write the performance appraisal of that particular employee. अचानक काय करायला, म्हणजे काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला, इन्स्पेक्शन. ओके, सडन इन्स्पेक्शन ऑर फोर्स. सपोज दे विल गिव यू टास्क, हां, फिनिश दिट वर्क, दिस वर्क इट विदिन हाफ एन आवर. ओके, दिस इज नथिंग बट अ फोर्स डिस्ट्रीब्युशन मेथड. मग ते 10 मिनिटात कोण करेल, 20 मिनिटात कोण करेल, ॲज पर दॅट ऑल्सो दे विल सिलेक्ट ऑर दे विल राईट द परफॉर्मन्स अप्रेजल ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पर्सन. हां, चेकलिस्ट मेथड. चेकलिस्ट इज नथिंग बट व्हॉट एव्हर द स्टँडर्ड फॉर्मॅट इज गिवन. ओके, ओनली वी हॅव टू चेक वेदर द हा दिस इज इनिशिएटिव्ह, येस टिक. ओके, सपोज दिस इज अ व्हेरी ऑनेस्ट, हा टिक. ओके, व्हॉट इज दिस इज अ टाइम कन्झ्युमिंग, हा नॉट, तिथं क्रॉस असेल. ओके, सो ऑलरेडी डिसाइडेड फॅक्टर्स, नाव वी हॅव टू ओनली चेक वेदर दिस इज येस ऑर नॉट, येस ऑर नॉट. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द मेथड ऑफ द परफॉर्मन्स अप्राइजल. ओके, फ्री एस सी मेथड. ओके,
free AC method. Now this type of is performance appraisal method is a exam type. Okay, suppose if you consider in military section, okay, or in defense sector, there are also number of exams are there. Because why? Now work overall work of employee is same. ओके जिथं जिथं वर्क सेमच आहे. आता आर्मीमध्ये काय शक्यतो वर्क सेमच असते. समजा एक बटालियन असेल, ओके, त्या बटालियनचं वर्क काय आहे, दे हॅव टू कॉन्सन्ट्रेट ओनली दॅट एरिया. ओके, सपोज जम्मू काश्मीर किंवा इनसाईड किंवा स्टेट लेवलला असेल किंवा CRPF असेल, ओके, BSF असेल. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दॅट द वर्क ऑफ ओव्हरऑल एम्प्लॉय इज सेम. ओके, बट देन इफ वर्क इज सेम, okay, and all the performance or all the employees are giving same work, then there is a difficulty to find out the comparison or ranking. Okay, so that time we have to take the examination. Okay, so which examination? Physical examination may be there, written example may be there, SC example may be there, what is your knowledge, what is your experience. Okay, so all the factors we will get from that pre-SC method. Okay, so SC method is nothing but we have to take a written information from the particular employee. So that is nothing but the AC method. Now graphic scales. Now what is a graphic scale? This is a graphical method. Okay, suppose we have to, for example, according to pie chart, okay, different charts, so we will take also analysis. For example, we are sending the Google form to each and every student, okay, for the whatever the feedback, okay, at the end of any workshop or any technical event. Is it right? So that time we will get idea definitely whatever the output of that feedback will be get in terms of graphic scale. Okay, so according to them we can also find out the, or we can set the performance appraisal of that particular employee. Is it right? So these factors are very important for the performance appraisal. Is it right? Huh. If any doubt is there, then you can ask me. Next point is the same point. Okay, so what is the output, what is the actual performance, and if any correction. So system approach to the performance appraisal, we can say that. Okay. So watch this chart. Okay, if any, you will get idea. So what is actually procedure of that system approach to the management. So see for 1 minute. Now what is the input, okay, and what is the output? Now okay, inputs, what are the input setting variable objective, the objectives that become standard. Now at the time of performance appraisal, first point is a setting variables objectives that become standard. Okay, or you have to decide what are the criteria, okay, which criteria is required to find, identify the performance appraisal of employee. So this is nothing but input, only setting variable objectives. Okay, so after that performance appraisal, and at the end of output, okay, what will be the output measuring performance against standards. Okay, so whatever the standard we have decided, okay, whatever standard we have decided, so according to the input standard we can get idea, we can measure the performance against the standard. Now formal comprehensive review, example annually. Okay, formal comprehensive review is nothing but whatever the overall review, you can say that vyapak kiwa sarvasamaveshak mhanto apan jala. Okay, formal comprehensive review, example annually. Okay, now progress or periodic reviews, example for milestones, quarterly, monthly, continuous monitoring daily with emphasis on self control. Okay, now there are basic 3 points: comprehensive, progressive, and continuous monitoring. Suppose daily monitoring may also there. Okay, suppose what is a, now this type of continuous monitoring is at the bottom level definitely, because bottom level workers will be continuously in contacting with or contacting with that particular supervisor. Okay, supervisor will view or whatever the they will monitor you daily or whatever the routinely. So this is nothing but a continuous monitoring. Okay, so what is the next step? Corrective actions for the undesirable deviation from the standard. Now why this performance appraisal, if there any correctiveness is required, okay, correction is required. For example, any worker is not doing very well, so you will get whatever the instruction to them also. Okay, so what is the instruction? Definitely you will say, so that factors will be considered in your performance appraisal. Okay, so ekadan just as the quality department kiwa production department la asel, so the if any person is joining late to every day, so you will give the idea to them before write the performance appraisal. ओके म्हणजे काय लगेच परफॉर्मन्समध्ये त्याच्या टाकून द्यायचं नाही की एक दोन दिवस त्याला समज देणं म्हणतो आपण ज्याला. ओके सो दॅट फॅक्टर्स आर ऑल्सो इफ एनी करेक्टिव ॲक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड सो यू कॅन ऑल्सो गेट नाव अकॉर्डिंग टू द आउटपुट. ओके इफ द चेंज इन स्टँडर्ड्स इज रिक्वायर्ड. ओके म्हणजे काय होतं बघा, सपोज फॉर एक्झाम्पल इन 2020 काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला जानेवारी 2020 ओके म्हणजे तुम्ही स्टँडर्ड तयार केले असतील. ओके सपोज यू हॅव मेड दी स्टँडर्ड्स इन जानेवारी 2020 बट सडनली इन मार्च ऑर फेब्रुवारी कोविड इज कमिंग. ओके ड्यू टू द कोविड ऑल दी व्हॉट एव्हर द इज डिस्टर्ब. सो ॲट दी एंड ऑफ किंवा कंटिन्युअसली म्हणजे आता जर परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल करायचं असेल आपल्याला, सो वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर द दॅट कोविड सिच्युएशन ऑल्सो. ओके सो इफ एनी करेक्टिव ॲक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड यू हॅव टू चेंज द स्टँडर्ड्स ऑल्सो. Okay, now why, which standards? For example, when you will be in class. Okay, किंवा तुम्ही आता आपण जेव्हा वर्गात होता क्लासमध्ये त्यावेळेस काय वेगळं होतं प्रोसिजर काय असेल, जॉईनिंग असेल, लेट आला तरी काय. आता स्टँडर्ड्स इथं काय होते बघा की ऑनलाईन मोड इज डिफरंट, इज इट राईट? सो सम स्टँडर्ड ऑर करेक्टिव ॲक्शन शुड बी टेकन वाईल डुईंग दी सो इन युअर एक्झामिनेशन ऑल्सो. ओके सो university is given number of whatever they come to shortcuts to the students. Okay, because why? Because something is not very well. Okay, म्हणजे त्याच्यामुळे काय झालं कोविड सारख्या सिच्युएशन मध्ये तुमचे ऑनलाईन एक्झाम झाले. ओके नाव इफ ऑनलाईन एक्झाम इज देअर सो वॉट स्टुडंट विल फेस द प्रॉब्लेम. म्हणून काय केलं, ऑनलाईन एक्झाम इज बेस्ड ऑन MCQs only. So corrective action, as per the corrective action you will get the idea. Is it right? So that factors are very important for the performance appraisal. Okay, now after corrective action definitely your standard may change. Okay, now that change standard will compare to the output. So that cycle will be continuously for as per the performance appraisal whatever the standards. Okay, they may be formal, progressive or continuous monitoring may be there. Okay. So this is all about performance appraisal. Okay, now this is the procedure. This is the procedure to for the performance appraisal. Again same procedure je apan at the last chart madhe baghitla je thoda color marla. Okay, so establish performance standards. Okay, first step is we have to write down, we have to select the standards for the परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल. ओके कम्युनिकेट परफॉर्मन्स स्टँडर्ड. सो व्हॉट आर द स्टँडर्ड, किंवा तुम्ही एक फॉर्म बनवला आहे परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझलसाठी, तो लोकांना दिला, तो लोकांना नाही समजला तर काय, दॅट विल ऑल्सो डिफिकल्ट. सो वी हॅव टू अंडरस्टूड, वी हॅव टू कम्युनिकेट दॅट परफॉर्मन्स स्टँडर्ड टू इच अँड एव्हरी वन. इज इट राईट? म्हणजे आपण बघा साधारणपणे त्या काय म्हणतो बँकेत जरी गेलो आपण पैसे काढायला कुठं कधी, तर लगेच कोणाला विचार इथं काय लिहायचं, इथं काय लिहायचं. ओके सो दॅट शुड नॉट बी हॅपन. म्हणजे प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन इज देअर. त्यात स्टेट बँकेत तुम्ही जायला पाहिजे, बरोबर का? तुम्हाला लगेच सांगितलं जातं. इज राईट? इवन फॉर द रिझर्वेशन इन रेल्वे, आता काय ऑनलाईन झाल्यामुळे शक्यतो बंद झाले ते, पण पूर्वी ओके वेन ऑनलाईन सर्व्हिसेस वॉज नॉट देअर. सो प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टंट. मेजर परफॉर्मन्स आफ्टर स्टँडर्ड वी हॅव टू कम्पेअर स्टँडर्ड विथ द परफॉर्मन्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉय. ओके मेजरमेंट कम्पेअर परफॉर्मन्स टू स्टँडर्ड. Okay, major is nothing but we have to take measurement of that each and every performance of the employee. Okay, what is the output? Now that output we have to compare with whatever standard we have established in first step. Okay, now discuss the next step is to discuss the appraisal with the employee. Definitely discussion is also very important. Okay, what are the, because according to the discussion only, okay, they will, the whatever the employee will improve that yourself. Okay, our employee will improve himself definitely. So discussion of appraisal to the employee is also important part of the performance appraisal. Implement personal action. Okay, after discussion you will get the action or decision on to that particular person. Okay, so this is a procedure or standard way of performance appraisal. So hope you all have understood the performance appraisal very well. So only one point is remaining, okay, from that chapter training. So that training point we will finish in next lecture. Is it right? So if any doubt is there, okay, then you can ask me. So what we have learned today? Only performance appraisal, okay. So this is a very important one. So as a student, we have to think on that. So what will be the performance appraisal? So according to this study, you can change your whatever the behavior and whatever the work quality. Okay. हे लक्षात घ्या की इन इंडस्ट्रीमध्ये सुद्धा जाऊन तुमचं काय असणार आहे, ऑब्झर्वेशन असणार आहे. ओके, यू विल बी अंडर ऑब्झर्वेशन. इज इट राईट? सो फॉर द फ्युचर, ग्रेट फ्युचर, यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर दॅट फॅक्टर्स ऑल्सो. ओके, नाव वी हॅव टू, वेन एवर यू विल गेट एनी जॉब इन इंडस्ट्री, सो देअर विल बी वर्क will also you will get. Okay, so you will be able to understood, compare, or will be able to take the performance appraisal review of each and every employee. Okay, so for that purpose, म्हणजे हे दोघांसाठी आहे बघा, म्हणजे परफॉर्मन्स अप्रायझल घेणार मॅनेजरसाठी आहे किंवा एम्प्लॉयसाठी आहे. सो बोथ वॉट एवर द ऑर्गनायझेशनल मॅनेजमेंट लेवल अँड वॉट एवर द नेक्स्ट वर्किंग लेवल, सो दिस इज अ रिक्वायर्ड फॉर बोथ डिपार्टमेंट. ओके, हां, सो ट्रेनिंग पार्ट इज द लास्ट, सो वी विल टेक ट्रेनिंग पार्ट. आफ्टर ट्रेनिंग पार्ट चॅप्टर विल फिनिश. ओके, ओनली वन पॉईंट इज रिमेनिंग. इट राईट? So what we have studied today, now what is the definition, okay, performance definition, performance appraisal, what is the output, objective of the performance appraisal, benefits of performance appraisal, different benefits, limitations, advantages, disadvantages, we can say that, methods of performance appraisal. Okay, basic 7 methods are there. So we have discussed within shortly, okay, ranking method, paired comparison method, grading system, force distribution method, okay, checklist method, pre-EC method, graphic scales. So that are the methods for the performance appraisal. Okay, this is a flow chart of the system approach to the performance appraisal. Okay, this is the standard way again. Okay, methodology of the performance appraisal, we can say that. Methodology of performance appraisal. Okay, start from establishment of the standards and last from implementing personal action. So that is the methodology for the performance appraisal. Okay, hope you all have understood the chapter very well. Okay, so only last point is remaining. Training after aadhunika asal development, training development. Okay, so we will finish that point in next lecture. Okay, so all of you, I think share study material is you are having or not, I don't know, so I will check. So this is a study material. Okay, so all the updated, whatever the videos, whatever the notes, PPTs, I have updated here. Okay, those who have not given MCQ test, okay, so I will take action on them also. Okay, so if any MCQ test will be published, okay, definitely within same day we have to finish that test. Okay, so keep in mind this is a very important. Okay, so I will consider attendance based on only that quiz, okay, or that MCQ test. So today I will also upload here lecture, performance appraisal. Okay, so 13 lectures we have made up to date, only 12 lectures for the theoretical and 1 lecture for MCQ test. Okay, so I will stop recording here. So thank you very much for attending this lecture. Okay, I will take attendance, don't leave.